Great. So, morning everyone. I'm John Zumbrunnen. I am in the political science department, and in particular I teach political theory or political philosophy. And I'm going to talk a bit this morning about the use I've been making of the peer grader function in Canvas in this class, which is a junior-senior seminar, topics in political science, and my topic is the political theory of the American Revolution. So this is a course where we start somewhere back in, say, the 1760s, and we're reading a lot of the pamphlet literature on both sides of the Atlantic during the 1760s and 1770s. We built up to the Declaration of Independence, and we're trying to think about the arguments made by both Loyalists and revolutionaries in that period. So as I was saying, the course that I'm going to talk a little bit about is this one, Political Theory of the American Revolution. The teaching challenge, so I am assigning a seminar research paper for the course, so the students are going to end up writing me a research paper of about 20 pages. And it's a staged research paper, so I'll show in a minute that I have them turning in four preliminary stages before they give me the final draft during finals week. I like doing peer review on most all student papers I assign. I find that I get, it saves me a little bit of work because the students come up with comments, oftentimes comments I would make, sometimes comments I had not thought of. And there's also a nice reinforcement of what I'm saying if their peers are saying it about their paper as well. I've always done peer review in class, but in this class I don't want to give up the class time. I'd rather have that be devoted to discussion. So I've been trying out using the peer review function on Canvas. So I will jump into my course here and first just show you the basics of the assignment. I don't know if this is the easiest way to do this in Canvas, because like everyone, I'm just figuring Canvas out, but for this staged assignment, I've basically just created a separate assignment for each stage, so I'm going to just talk about these first two stages, because those are what students have done so far. So here's the preliminary paper idea stage of the research paper assignment, here's the annotated bibliography stage, and I've got peer reviews on both of those so far. The assignment is a very traditional research paper assignment, and here's the stages. Preliminary paper idea, an annotated bibliography, which is something most of my students have never done before. Coming up soon, an introductory paragraph and a full paper outline, and then a draft of at least 6 pages prior to the final version being due, as I said, during finals week. So, for the preliminary paper idea, because I had no idea what topic students were going to write on, we did peer review on this, but I simply had Canvas randomly assign peer reviews. So this is very easy to do. I just come down here on the assignment page, click require peer reviews, tell Canvas to automatically assign peer reviews, and tell it that I want 3 reviews per user, which also means each student is doing 3 reviews. And I can set the time and day when Canvas is going to assign those reviews. This part becomes important. The assignment of reviews has to come after the due date, and if I don't put anything there, it just uses the due date as the time when it's going to assign peer reviews. We'll say that we're done there. I'll jump into SpeedGrader to show you an example of what students can come in and do. They are able to do everything in terms of commenting that the instructor can do in SpeedGrader. So it looks like in a couple weeks you're having someone do SpeedGrader, is that right? So if you haven't used SpeedGrader in Canvas, everyone I know who uses it falls in love with it. It really increases the speed of grading, as the name would suggest, and it gives you wonderful things to do. There's 3 different ways that you can insert marginal comments. You can draw freehand. you can strike out passages and add your own replacement text form. You can see here that what the students mostly did was use the comment function where you can highlight a chunk of text and write comments. We see that he's offered up a lot of different comments, including some comments to really push his classmate here. Then over here we have other students who were a little less active. So we've got some other students here who have just come in and added some summary comments. And then at the end somewhere would be my, there's comments from me as well. What I found going through these is I didn't have to add a lot of my own comments because the students had pretty much said on each of the preliminary ideas what I would have said myself. So a lot of times I'm going in and simply adding my summary comments here because the students are pretty good at this. So this is an example of the peer review process working well. It serves the purpose of getting students to work on these research papers early. I like the added side benefit that students are getting to learn from their classmates, not just in terms of the feedback they're getting, but they're getting to see what their peers are doing. And I tell them, I don't care if you borrow from one another, right? Obviously, I don't want plagiarism, but especially in the next stage, as I'll explain, I want them to be drawing on one another's work. One little wrinkle that I did not anticipate goes back to that fact that Canvas, if you don't tell it when to assign peer reviews, will assign them on the due date at the due hour at the due moment. So 11:59 p.m. it's going to assign peer reviews at 12 a.m. That becomes a problem when a student submits a paper late, because if the paper is 5 minutes late, Canvas has already assigned the peer reviews. And when you are trying to distribute the peer reviews randomly among the students who have submitted things, this student ends up both without any peer reviews on his work, but also without any peer reviews to complete. So what I had to do on this was ask the class for a couple of volunteers to participate in a peer review with this student. So lesson learned for next time is probably to wait, set that due date or set that assignment date out a week or something, and then go back and change it to have Canvas do it when I know everybody submitted their work.
Have you pursued that, John, to see if is Canvas aware of this instructor, aware of this?
I don't even know that I would consider it an issue with Canvas so much as an issue with me. I mean, it honestly, it tells me right there that that's what it's going to do.
Okay.
So I just, if I had read that and been more careful about it.
But there's no button that you found that says assign, where you can manually assign somebody.
We can dig into that.
There is manual assignment, and I'm going to talk about manual assignment right now.
Okay.
A button that says assign peer reviews now would be great.
Like instead of saying, yes. Especially when it says it was submitted late, therefore I acknowledge there's nobody there.
So if I go to assignments now and go to my annotated bibliography. So this is the second stage. I'm just having them go out and find a few sources, give me the proper citation for each source, and write a paragraph about what they think the source says and how it's going to be relevant to their paper assignment. So for this one, I did things a little bit differently. Now I know, based on the preliminary paper ideas, what they're writing about. And I spent some time looking at the range of topics and thinking about which students would be best to comment on one another's work going forward. So I formed basically working groups for the research paper assignment I did. It's a class of 15, so I formed five groups of three. And I'm thinking when I'm assigning those groups in, mostly about substance, which topics make the most sense, who's going to be able to help each other most, who's going to be able to share secondary sources the most. But I also looked a little bit at trying, honestly, sometimes to pair strong students with strong students, or sometimes to think about, well, here's a student who's going to struggle a little more in the class, it would be great to pair them with a strong peer. There's a real balancing act to do there, because I got three or four students in this class who are capable of doing graduate level work, and I put three of them in the same team just to try to get them to push one another and see if they can't take off and do some excellent work. So a little bit of balancing and thinking about that. What I did to turn those working groups into peer review groups is, instead of having Canvas randomly assign peer reviews, I came down here and clicked manually assign peer reviews. That made for a little bit of busy work for me because I had to go in and actually do those assignments. It's really easy in Canvas because it's just a matter of clicking on the student names to assign those peer reviews. It was easy in a class of 15. If this were a bigger class, I'm not going to want to go through that process of assigning manually assigning peer reviews. I'm really curious about this box, making it a group assignment. So I've used the group assignment function in Canvas where I'm really assigning a group of students to do a project and they're producing one product for me. I don't know, and I need to play around with this, if I, for this kind of assignment where each student's submitting something separately and then I want them to do peer review, if I can treat that as a group assignment and allow multiple submissions from different students, I don't know if that will work. I don't think so. I think I probably have to go through this process of assigning the peer reviews to my research groups. Alongside the peer review work for the annotated bibliography, I did also create groups for each of the formal Canvas group for each of the working groups, and I gave them each their own discussion forum. I encouraged them to go in the discussion forum and share with one another what they're working on, any concerns. They have not yet been particularly active in the discussion forums. It's the one thing that's interesting is in group three, these two posts are both from the same student, and she went in once and posted about her preliminary paper idea, and she came back about a week later and said, hey, I'm thinking about changing my idea in this way. There's an awesome opportunity for some group interaction there, they just haven't done it yet. That's partly on them, it's partly also on me. I've been playing with this as I have gone along, and I did not know that I was gonna create a discussion forum for working groups until the day I did it. If I had thought that through in advance, I would have put a little bit of a grade associated with this. Hey, you're gonna earn some points if you're active in the discussion forum. I think that would have taken care of it quite well. The only other thing I would note back here on this, and we'll just go to speed. Nope, it won't let me go to speed grade again. The comments on the annotated bibliography, they were a little slow in posting those peer reviews, much slower than they were the first time. And the second thing is I'm not sure peer reviews on the annotated bibliography are going to be as useful as on the preliminary paper ideas. And later on when there's actually writing for them to respond to. I think a lot of the comments on the annotated bibliography are going to be of this, hey, you're off to a good start, right? Honestly, as I said before, I'm hopeful that what will come out of this stage of this staged research paper project is that they're going to steal sources from one another, because I would really love for them to do that. Yeah.
So, just thinking, if you had peer reviews of the preliminary ideas, wouldn't it be useful to have the same peer reviews assigned to the bib so that people could see how those ideas were coming forward in the sources?
So I think that would be a great idea, and the reason I didn't do it this time is because I didn't know in advance of those preliminary paper ideas what the topics were going to be, and I wanted, in the later stages, I wanted to have kind of coherent working groups of students who were pursuing similar topics. Like, here's one working on Jefferson, here's someone working on Tom Paine. It kind of makes sense to stick them together, right? Now, had I planned farther in advance for all of this, then what I would have done is have them submit submit a very basic two sentence, here's what I'm thinking of working on, so that before that first stage was even submitted, I could have put them in working groups, right? That probably, but I struggled with this too, because the other thing is once I formed those working groups, I've effectively worked to close off communication between across working groups. So I've thought about, are there ways I can think about having the working groups, but then also having a component of random review, or else open it up so that everybody can see everybody's work, right? And just require it. I don't know. There's a lot. As I say, this was sort of done on the fly of, hey, peer review is cool. And honestly, it wasn't just that there's a peer review function in Canvas. It's that it uses the speed grader tool, because that just allows students to do so much. So, you know, I'm making this up on the fly, and I think I've learned that kind of question is one I want to plan out better in advance.
Are you able to demonstrate or to display what it looks like from the student's view? You have a student, like, so they've gotten these assignments. Where does that show up? How do they see that?
They've gotten their peer review assignments.
Yeah.
I don't know if it will let, do you know, John, will it let me do, because if I go to student view, that's not going to help. Yeah, and I'll tell you, I've wondered exactly this question, like, so
obviously
it's
working.
Yeah, they find their peer reviews to do, so it, but yeah, at 12:05 a.m. after Canvas has assigned their peer reviews, what does it tell them? I don't know the answer to that. Does it? I'm assuming that if they are using the dashboard, just like it tells me that, you know, I got a lot of grading to work on, I'm assuming it pops up over here for them that they have peer reviews.
Okay. Yes.
I'll get a chance to dig into this. Julie, I believe we're all students at the beginning?
Not right now, but I can make you students.
All right, make us all students, and then when we get to the hands-on thing, we're going to have you all do a quick assignment.
That's perfect.
Yeah.
And then you get to see what it looks like, and you'll do a student peer review of each other's, and we can answer a lot of these questions.
That's all I've got.
All right.
If people have more questions for me.